Laudato Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. Hello and welcome to this live broadcast of the recitation of the Angelus coming to you from St. Peter's Square in the Vatican. It's the 26th of December and we're still celebrating the Feast of Christmas. Those of you watching on television can see the Christmas tree erected in St. Peter's Square. Today the church also marks a feast of St. Stephen, the first Christian martyr. Pope Francis will soon be coming to the window of the Apostolic Palace and greeting us before praying the traditional Marian prayer of the Angelus, as he does every Sunday on a major feasts like today. The Pope will then impart his apostolic blessing, which goes out to all the faithful gathered in St. Peter's Square, quite a big crowd today for this Feast of St. Stephen, and also goes out to all of you watching or listening to this broadcast live. My name is Joseph Tollock, and on behalf of Vatican Media, I'd like to welcome you all to this broadcast, whether you're joining us via the various Vatican Media channels, perhaps the Vatican News website, the Vatican News English YouTube channel, or our Facebook live feed, or whether you're joining us via our official partner radio and television stations, Catholic TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks, Salt and Light TV, EWN TV, Radio Maria England, Shalom TV, At Madison TV, Uganda Catholic Television, and Luminous Radio India, or via any radio station anywhere in the world. Wherever and however you're listening to this broadcast, you're most welcome. And those of you again watching on television can see now a shot of the nativity scene in St. Peter's Square. And as I said, we're still celebrating the Feast of Christmas, so maybe now's a good moment to talk about the Pope's traditional Urbi et Orbi address, which he delivered yesterday, greeting the crowds gathered in St. Peter's Square from the central loggia of St. Peter's Basilica. The Pope offered his traditional good wishes. Urbi et Orbi is Latin for to the city and to the world. And as he does every Christmas and every Easter, the Pope read out a message and then offered the Urbi et Orbi blessing. The Pope said that we, in these days, look to the birthplace of Jesus in Bethlehem. He said that our times are sadly marked by sorrow and silence, yet the birth of the Saviour gives us a great hope, he said, as the Lord has been born for us, the eternal word of the Father, the infinite God, has made his home among us. Following the birth of the Saviour came the slaughter of the innocents, the Pope recalled, and he remembered the innocents, the little Jesuses of today, he said, who are victims, whether in their mothers' wombs, in odysseys undertaken in desperation and in search of hope, in the lives of all those little ones whose childhood has been devastated by war. We must say yes to peace and no to war, the Pope decried, as every war marks a defeat without victors, a quote, inexcusable folly. He also called for a no to weaponry, given that with human weakness we can often end up using it for war sooner or later. Peace, he said, is even more difficult, because when arms production, sales and trade are on the rise, and public funds spent on arms can come at the expense of bread for the hungry. He decried the interests and the profits that move the puppet strings of war, and said that these must be brought to light, talked about and written about, since many have no idea how much of their public funds are being spent on weapons. He prayed that with God's help, we may make every effort for the day when nation shall not lift sword against nation. The Pope thought in particular of the Holy Land and prayed for an end to the war devastating the lives of the people in Israel and Palestine. Here a shot of the window from which Pope Francis will shortly be giving his address. And speaking yesterday, the Pope offered his consolation to the people of Gaza and the entire region, and in particular the Christian communities there. And now we see Pope Francis starting to appear at that window in the Apostolic Palace, and we prepare ourselves to listen to his message for today's feast.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning. Today, straight after Christmas, we celebrate the Feast of St. Stephen, the first martyr. We find the account of his martyrdom in the Acts of the Apostles, which describe him as a man of good repute, who served food to the poor and administered charity. Precisely for this generous integrity, he cannot but bear witness to what is most precious to him, to testify to his faith in Jesus. And this unleashes the wrath of his adversaries, who stone him to death mercilessly. And this all happens in front of a young man, Saul, a zealous persecutor of Christians, who acts as a guarantor of the execution. Let us think a moment about this scene. Saul and Stephen, the persecutor and the persecuted. There seems to be an impenetrable wall between them, as hard as the fundamentalism of the young Pharisee and the stones thrown at the man condemned to death. And yet, beyond appearances, there is something stronger that unites them. Indeed, through Stephen's witness, the Lord is already preparing in Saul's heart, unbeknownst to him, the conversion that will lead him to be the great Apostle Paul. Stephen, his service, his prayer, and the faith he proclaims, his courage, and especially his forgiveness at the point of death, are not in vain. There are times of persecution even today, and it's right to say this. Even today, the blood of the martyrs is the seed of the church. These two seem to end in nothing, but in reality, Stephen's sacrifice plants a seed that, going in the opposite direction to the stones, plants itself in a hidden way in the breast of his worst rival. Today, 2,000 years later, unfortunately, we see that the persecution continues. There is persecution of Christians. There are still those, and there are many of them, who suffer and die to bear witness to Jesus, just as there are those who are penalized at various levels for the fact of acting in a way consistent with the gospel, and those who strive every day to be faithful without ado to their good duties, while the word jeers and preaches otherwise. These brothers and sisters too may also seem to be failures, but today we see that this is not the case. Now as then, in fact, the seed of their sacrifices, which seems to die, germinates and bears fruit, because God, through them, continues to work miracles, changing hearts and saving men and women. Let us ask ourselves then, do I care about and pray for those who, in various parts of the world, still suffer and die for the faith? There are many who are killed for their faith, and in turn, do I try to bear witness to the gospel consistently with meekness and confidence? Do I believe that the seed of goodness will bear fruit even if I do not see immediate results? May Mary, Queen of Martyrs, help us to bear witness to Jesus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedicto frutto ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Ut digni officiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, che angelo annunziante, Christi Filii tui, incarnazione coniovim, per passione meius ad crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamo, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Santo.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce a Teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen. Amen.
And that was the recitation of the Marian Angelus prayer. And dear brothers and sisters, Pope Francis says, I renew my wishes of peace to all of you on this Feast of the Nativity of the Lord. And I take this occasion to thank all those who sent messages of good wishes to me from Rome and all parts of the world. Thank you especially for your prayers. And please continue to pray for the Pope. It's necessary. And given this witness of Saint Stephen, there are many Christian communities that are suffering persecution, and they are fighting peacefully for peace and for religious freedom. Through the intercession of the first martyr, I also entrust to this first martyr other communities suffering from war. We've seen in Syria, we see Gaza, we think of martyred Ukraine, a desert of death. This is what people want. They want peace. Let us pray for peace. Let us fight for peace. I address you all, and I greet you all, Romans, groups of parishes, religious associations. I invite you to wait in prayer in front of the great nativity scene in St. Peter's Square, which is inspired by the one made by St. Francis in Greccio 800 years ago. Look at the statues and see in their faces and in their behavior a common trait. Wonder. You'll see wonder. You'll see wonder which becomes worship. And let us be struck by this wonder in front of the birth of the Lord. I wish you that you might keep this within yourselves, this wonder that becomes worship. Thank you to all of you, the young children from the Immaculata, and a good feast to you all. And please do not forget to pray for me. Have a good lunch and arrivederci. And so that brings to an end this live broadcast of this recitation of the Noonday Angelus with Pope Francis in St. Peter's Square on the Feast of St. Stephen. Today we heard a reflection from the Holy Father on the figure of St. Stephen, and he noted that St. Stephen's martyrdom played a role in the conversion of St. Paul, suggesting that the many martyrs who suffer today have the same ability to convert hearts. And he ended by encouraging us to ask ourselves whether we pray for those who are suffering and dying for the faith today, and whether we too are trying to bear consistent witness to the gospel. For more news about the Pope and the worldwide church over this Christmas season, please do visit the Vatican News website. You can find us at www.vaticannews.va. And please do take a look at our Facebook, Instagram, X, and YouTube accounts too. Just search Vatican News. We'll be back again live tomorrow with the Pope's general audience starting at around 9 a.m. Rome time. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to thank our in-studio audio technician Adriano Vitali and our audio coordinator Sister Bernadette Rice and all of our media partners who made this broadcast possible. But most of all, thank you to all of you for joining us today. I'm Joseph Tolek. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day and continue to have a very Merry Christmas. Laudate Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ.